In the second question that we have, it is given we have to find out what is true about NH2 minus, NH3 and NH4 plus. These four options are given. So for this answering this question, we have to directly draw the structure of the three given ions and the NH3 molecule. Therefore, let us first go with NH2 minus. This negative charge is on the central atom. Therefore, nitrogen now has 6 electrons in its outermost shell. It needs to complete its octet. Therefore, it will take 2 hydrogen atoms and take 2 electrons from them. Therefore, out of the 6, the 2 will be consumed in making bonds with hydrogen. Therefore, it will have 2 pairs of lone pair. Therefore, the steric number of the atom will come out to be 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. Now, for steric number equal to 4, we know that the hybridization will be equal to sp3. Therefore, on drawing the figure, it will be like tetrahedral geometry. 1H here, 1H here, 1 lone pair here and 1 lone pair here. Therefore, we get the structure for NH2 minus. Let us draw the structure for NH3. Nitrogen has 5 electrons in its outermost shell. It will bond with 3 of them to form or to complete its octet, and it will have 1 remaining lone pair. Therefore, the steric number will be equal to 3 plus 1 is equal to 4 again. The hybridization will be sp3 because of 4 steric number, 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. Therefore, the geometry will again be tetrahedral. The figure will be something like this. Now, for NH4 plus, the nitrogen will be having only 4 electrons in its outermost shell. Now, 4 electrons in outermost shell will combine with the 4 hydrogen atoms to complete the octet of nitrogen. Therefore, it will be having 0 lone pairs of electron. Therefore, the steric number will be equal to the number of neighboring atoms, that is equal to 4. Therefore, the hybridization is again sp3 and the geometry again is tetrahedral. Here we have a negative charge on the nitrogen atom. Here we have a positive charge on the nitrogen atom. This is one hydrogen here, one hydrogen here, one hydrogen here and another hydrogen here. This is a tetrahedral figure in which the three hydrogen atoms are arranged like this and one hydrogen atom is on the top. Similarly, for both these figures, therefore, we now look at the options. Hybridization of nitrogen is same, is correct. In all the three, the hybridization of nitrogen is sp3. We look at the second option, number of lone pair of electrons on nitrogen is same. This is false. The number of lone pair is 0 here, 1 here and 2 here. Therefore, this option is wrong. The geometry is same, right? Because the geometry is in all the three cases is tetrahedral. Geometry is the arrangement of the atoms in space, that is tetrahedral over here. We look at the fourth option, that is bond angle is same in all the four cases, which is again wrong because here we have two lone pairs, here we have one lone pair. Therefore, we'll be having different kinds of lone pair, bond pair repulsions, due to which the bond angles will be different in all the three cases. Here we will be having more lone pair, bond pair repulsion, and here we will be having lesser lone pair, bond pair repulsion. Here we don't have any lone pair. Therefore, the bond angles in all the three cases will be different. So, again, we get this option as wrong. So, final answer is that in all these three compounds, the hybridization of nitrogen is same and the geometry of the compound is same.